3 people are dead and 100 arrests have been made in the aftermath of 3 days of violence in the Solomon Islands. Australia's Defence Force is tonight in Honiara amid a push for calm to be restored.
Sunrise in Honiara, and with it, hopes of peace. The streets are scarred by the impacts of fires, riots and looting, and now it appears deadly. Local police say 3 bodies have been found. After 3 days of anti-government protests, Saturday has been calmer, but the violence and looting, which resulted in 100 arrests, has also created concerns of a food shortage.
Sad state here.
There's worries too over fuel and cash supplies. Arriving to help restore calm and protect ports and airports, 67 men and women from Australia's Defence Force flying into Honiara last night. Federal police are already on the ground in uniform and carrying shields to help one of Australia's closest neighbours.
Our concern is for the people of the Solomon Islands and ensuring that they can enjoy the type of peace and security that they deserve.
I hope that there can be peaceful resolution of order.
Solomon Islands journalist Gina Kakia has watched as parts of Honiara have erupted and shops have been raided.
Today is a better day. Everyone's feeling better as well.
But political tensions remain amid growing calls for Prime Minister Manasa Sogavare to quit over economic tensions and a decision to side with Beijing over Taiwan. While the streets are calmer today, hospital staff are stretched, local clinics have been closed, health authorities, police and the Governor General pleading for peace.
We must not forget the importance of respect for each other and the importance of working together.
An indefinite nighttime curfew is in place from tonight.
As the saying goes, united we stand, divided we fall.
A hope of longer-term peace on these troubled streets. Jonathan Kersley, Nine News.